I moved to America 14 years ago. I've been inspired by North America for many years, but now I produce a line in Peru because I want to keep it closer, South America and North America. And basically I'm being inspired by cities of North America and all cities in South America too in this collection. I love the comfort of the United States. I like the way how people dress here because they like the natural fabrics, they like organic, they want to be comfortable. And that's what we have in Peru. We produce beautiful Pima cotton and for winter baby alpaca mixed with silk, and it's very comfortable for the body, and that's what Americans like. And basically right now the colors and everything for this collection comes from Lima a little bit, because Lima is a very dark city. It's very foggy. It's like San Francisco, believe it or not. It's a South American city, but during winter time it's very, very gothic, dark kind of, especially downtown Lima. And that's where the collection comes from a little bit. Yeah.
So let's talk about the fabrics. I mean, these are really gorgeous. I love the detailing that you have. Can you tell me a little bit about the texture?
These are wools from Peru also. And we actually did all this embroidery with like these silver attachments. And here is this coat made with baby alpaca, and it keeps you very warm, and it's very soft. It doesn't itch or anything, and people really like that. And for the girls also, this is cotton, but it's like a jaguar, it's called. It's you can do any kind of prints with the machines and everything, but it's like a little dress or a top, you know, for example.
So with this dress, you've got the three different pins. Do you select do those come with your garment?
Well, what I did is I went to all these vintage fabric stores in Peru, and where they have all these accessories from the 50s, and I got them and I put them in the collection. All the pieces are vintage, and some of them are real gold also, that I have an artist in Peru. Peru is one of the biggest producers in gold in the world. It's the biggest producer in silver, and maybe one of the biggest in gold. And that's why the accessories represents that too, yeah. Wow.
Yeah, because I would say that you don't normally find clothes for menswear, especially adorned like you have them here. It's really unique.
Yeah, this is something for a guy that is in New York or in a big city like Buenos Aires, Sao Paulo, or like Chicago, and he wants to have fun at night. This is a piece for that, you know?
So tell me where you can find your lines in America.
We actually have, we own three stores right now in South America, and we are reopening in September here because we are having our women's line, we're launching our women's line here, and we're having a store in the West Village starting from September. I like to show like 80% of the line menswear and 20% women's, because I started as a menswear designer, and I like to take step by step. Yeah, I didn't know anybody here in New York, but what I did is I rent a space, because I sold already in San Francisco, that gave me the confidence to come here. I opened my little store here in the West Village, and that's how I met my friends and my clients, and now we're here, yeah.
Wow, so that was a really courageous thing. Yeah. Did you have to get investors to open that store, or was it just from
I did it with my own money. Till today, I don't have any investors. We did everything ourselves.
Oh, man, that must make you feel really good.
But we're ready for that, actually, to make it to the next level.
Right. Yeah. So how many years have you been showing at Mercedes-Benz Festival?
This is my show number 5. At New York Fashion Week. Yeah.
Excellent.